Anime movies tend to be continuations of existing series, a recap movie, action thrillers, or relaxing Ghibli-esque fantasies. Sometimes, the shortened length of these anime films have a story asking more questions than given answers to. However, the shorter length allows animators to make the film a marvel to look at. Letter to Momo is no exception. It takes a simple concept and turns it into something new, with unique and believable characters and a 7-long journey from concept to creation. I'm Nano, and today on Animoto Reviews, a review of Momo e no Tegami, Letter to Momo, a heartwarming coming-of-age story set in modern-day Japan with a touch of fantasy. Letter to Momo introduces us to Momo, a shy girl who is in the process of moving into island life with her mother Ikuko, after the recent passing of her father. Lonely and uncomfortable in her new surroundings, Momo is left with an unfinished letter from her father with only the words Dear Momo written on it. Momo and Ikuko meet old friends and relatives, and soon enough, Ikuko begins to take nursing classes, leaving Momo home alone. While exploring the rather large estate, Momo finds a small decorated box containing a rare picture book, and doesn't think much of it, brushing it off as merely a collectible. A short while later, she begins to hear strange noises around the house, and soon enough, she encounters 3 rather strange yokai, guardians, sent to watch over Momo and Ikuko whilst her late father moves into above, or this world's version of heaven. The main part of the movie follows Momo and the yokai in their daily life, all while trying to solve the meaning behind the words Dear Momo. The film also focuses a great part on Momo and Ikuko's recuperating relationship, as well as building trust with the island folk, and shares many similarities with Summer Wars and Wolf Children in that regard. Letter to Momo spends a great deal of time letting you get to know the characters, and makes the ending all the more easy to want to bawl your eyes out. On some occasions, it felt like the story needed to get to finding out what was the deal with the letter, but the story was constructed in a way where you would be pleasantly surprised with what was coming next. The director and writer, Hiroyuki Okiura, was previously responsible for the writing and direction of Jinro, and has a long backstory as an animator from age 16, so Letter to Momo is his first major project. It'll be interesting to see what he does in the future, and hopefully there's better work to come from him. First up, we have 11-year-old Momo, our aforementioned shy protagonist. Momo is heartbroken from her father's passing and is left to cope with moving to an island, an awkward relationship with her mother, and the possibilities of a forced romance to boot. Next up, we have Ikuko, Momo's mother. She's a calm and collected character, and acts as someone to force Momo into a more comfortable lifestyle. Did I mention that she has severe asthma that... Getting our 2 female leads out of the way, we have Yota, the aforementioned supposed love interest, and his little sister Umi, Ikuko's old friend now turned postman, and the 2 grandparents. Finally, we have the 3 yokai. Kawa, Mame, and Iwa. No, but you can definitely see a bit of the 3 stooges projected onto the 3 guardians. The 3 are quirky in their own ways, and although the 3 don't grow that much as characters, the wild personalities of the 3 contrast Momo's more timid nature, and in turn, we are able to see Momo grow as a person throughout the film. The yokai act as a catalyst to move the plot forward, and not one moment is wasted on the screen to throw in little bits of comedy, or to show how easily Momo can end their journey on Earth by breaking a wooden tablet. As far as character backstory goes, Momo and Ikuko get just enough to explain their actions and give the viewer a reason to care, but much of the yokai's background is unexplored and leaves the viewer wanting to know more about the supernatural world of the yokai. And if a large green guardian resembling a certain ogre isn't enough for you, you might be happy to know that there is a whole army of creatures that vary in color, shape, and size. Letter to Momo is a hand-drawn masterpiece, and the 7-year work in progress was definitely worth the wait. Animated by Production IG, the production staff definitely knows what they're doing. The setting was entirely based off the area around the Seto Inland Sea. The painter responsible for the backgrounds was Hiroshi Ono, known for his work on Kiki's Delivery Service for his painting-like yet realistic backgrounds. The characters fit in well with the backdrops and had their own personality just by looking at them. As for sound, the ending theme fits well with the mood of the film and plays several times during its duration, and the soundtrack does a good job complementing the series. The composer for the soundtrack, Mina Kubota, is a less well-known composer who has worked on the soundtracks of Photo Kano, Kaleid of Star, and Kanazuki no Miko. He has also worked on several opening themes, such as the openings of Aria the Animation. As far as dub versus subs go, stick with the sub for Letter to Momo. The dub has a few problems. First of all, Ikuko sounds way younger than she should for a mother, and some of the performances sound forced or just don't work with the scene. Momo was played well considering that the voice actor, Amanda Pace, does not have very much experience in major roles such as this. However, these flaws don't make the dub unbearable, and in the sub, the characters feel a bit more lifelike and believable. Either is your choice, but if you were to go one way or the other, stick with the sub. Letter to Momo is a heartwarming coming-of-age story with unique characters, stunning animation, and is a relaxing viewing experience sure to leave you with a smile, and something to ponder after a long day. Themes of family and how the characters deal with the loss of a loved one can make you think if you're enjoying the precious times you have with the ones you love. Take a minute and spend some time with a loved one. You won't regret it. Letter to Momo is a fairly underrated film and deserves to be exposed to the anime community. For the time being, Letter to Momo earns a 7.9 for its story, as it felt a bit slow and lacked a bit of explanation in some bits, and 8.2 for its characters, as they were well-developed and unique, however lacked a bit of backstory. A 9.3 for animation, and an 8.7 for sound, as the animation was beautiful and made the world and story believable, and a soundtrack that added the missing piece to the experience. And finally, an 8.6 for overall enjoyment, for a final score of 8.54 out of 10. Letter to Momo is currently not available for legal streaming, however has been licensed by G-Kids in North America on DVD and Blu-ray. And that's all for today. Be sure to like and subscribe for more reviews, and leave a comment if you have something to say. And this has been Nano from Animal to Reviews. Sore ja, mata!